All right, Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashin, Yahweh Shah. Double honors to the elders at Green Millstone. And salutations to the Akin that's teaching the truth and sincerity. This is something like Elder Tahar doing Gmsimpromtu. I want to point something out about this hypocrite, this black devil formerly known as Nate, a.k.a. Law and Order Nate, a.k.a. Naughty by Nate. I want to point something out about this demon. And show how much he's of a hypocrite and a piece of shit that he is. Alright? Let's play this scum lord of Gotham City.
You think I am a conspiracy theorist? One thing you'll find out about me, I am not a conspiracy theorist. A conspiracy theorist generally is a nut. A crazy person. There's a lot of conspiracy theorists on YouTube. Have you ever seen the Muppets when they go, and they all run across the screen like that? That's a lot of these guys. Conspiracy theorists are nuts that point out plans to destroy a society of people. But those people that pointed...
Let's show you that this dude's a jackass, and he don't even know the meaning of the words, okay? Conspiracy just simply means to plot, okay? When you go into the etymology of the word, it means with breath, okay? That two people come to agreement with to do something. All right, it don't mean no. See, it shows you that he's a Babylonian Israelite, okay? Because he just, whatever the so-called white man says or whatever a doctrine that America pushes or demonized words that they demonize, he believes in that. He don't even know the true essence or the meaning of words. But I just wanted to go into this point because he says that conspiracy are nut jobs. But according to the so-called white man, your conspiracy, according to what you think the meaning of conspiracy is, you're a nutcase. You're a nut job. You're a bugged out nigga. And I'm approving, man. Because don't you believe that the UFOs are the chariots of Israel, are the chariots of God? Don't you believe that? Don't you push that? Oh, no, you don't push that. But don't you believe that? Okay. And I got proof that your men believes that the so-called UFOs are the chariots of Israel. But first, I want to point out the fact that the world pushes that this is a conspiracy, okay?
There is no evidence whatsoever of any life outside of our planet, or that any life outside our planet has contacted or engaged the human race. Thirdly, that the United States government, there is no credible information that it has been hiding any information about that from the American people. With all due respect to the White House and to the President, this statement is remarkable for three reasons. One, it is false. Two, it is indefensibly false. But three, and this is
what your office assigns. I'm going to play it back one more time. Basically, the three statements he just said is statements that the White House gave out about extraterrestrial life, life outside the Earth.
Policy that can be found on the Internet quite easily. This statement had three sentences. One, I paraphrase, there is no evidence whatsoever of any life outside of our planet, or that any life outside our planet has contacted or engaged the human race. And thirdly, that the United States government, there is no credible information that it has been hiding any information about that from the...
Which is all lies. It's all lies, which is bullshit, because the white man's the devil. He's a liar. He's a deceiver. Okay? But to show you that they think that the so-called extraterrestrials or the life forms outside the Earth aren't real. Okay? Let's go to something else.
Possible that the Air Force could have missed something in its investigation. In other words, is it possible that there are unidentified flying objects, that there are extraterrestrial visits, and the Air Force simply has not found it or been able to detect it?
We have researched the Air Force projects and the Air Force information for these year groups. We have nothing else to say about them. You know, we don't believe there's anything else. I have no way of even vaguely believing there's anything else. I promised the gentleman right back.
See? So they always trying to cover it up, because that's what the devil does, showing you that Nate is a devil, because he's trying to cover up that the Mark of the Beast is the RFID chip. Okay, he's trying to say that conspiracy theories are nut jobs, okay, which he's a conspiracy theorist because he believes in the so-called UFO. He believes that the UFOs are chariots, which makes him a nut job, okay? And then I want to point something else out. The whole world knows, even two-thirds of our people know, that there's a thing called the Illuminati. There's a thing called secret societies. Even two-thirds of our people know that. But you got to remember, it's a balance. There's always a balance to things. There's truth and there's lies, okay? There's lies that's being pushed out about the Illuminati, about certain shit that they do. And there's truth that's being pushed out about the Illuminati and the things that they do, okay? Same thing with the Mark of the Beast. It's truths about what the Mark of the Beast is, so that it's the RFID chip. And there's lies that the Mark of the Beast is a tattoo or something else, okay? An embargo, white women, sin, okay? There's truths and then there's lies, okay? It's that simple. But here's the proof. I wanted to make this short and sweet, okay? Here's the proof that his men believe that the so-called UFOs are chariots of Israel, which the government thinks is a conspiracy theory.
Now that's a chariot. That's what it's been doing all day, popping in and out. So we really want to focus on seeing the chariot. We're just explaining what we saw. Inspired by the title of what happened in the 90s, which was called the Phoenix Lights, we decided to call this the Bronx Lights. What we saw today are chariots. Basically, what happened was I was on the phone with one of the brothers in the school, talking, going over scriptures.
Okay, all right. Because they all got the spirit innate on them, okay? And that carrot, they just extra, they got an extra cult of personalities on them, you know? But right there, that just shows you that Nate and his men are a bunch of nut jobs, according to their high priest, Nathaniel, okay? The black devil formerly known as Nathaniel, okay? According to him, y'all a bunch of nut jobs, okay? Because you believe in the so-called UFOs. Showing you the hypocrisy of this demon, Naughty by Nate, okay? And something else I want to point out, okay? The revelation of the chariots came from the man known as Yeshaya. That's from the old school, One West, okay? Which according to Nate, everybody out of One West they was off. You had to leave the school and you had to go over the scripture 2 years and make sure that you was breaking down the scriptures right. Okay, but you say that the Lashawn Kadosh was a doctrine made by man. Well, it was a man that came down with the doctrine that the chariots was the so-called UFOs. So come on with the bullshit, man. Stop the BS, man. Cut the bullshit, Nate. And stop being a demon, man. You know, we know that you under that 501c3 charter. That's why you can't push out secret societies. Go into the true breakdown of the Mark of the Beast, which is the RFID chip. We understand that. Okay, you sold out. That simple. It's that simple, man. And I pray for the elect, whoever that might be amongst y'all, come out of that wickedness and stop following this demon, this Sinestro. I mean, this demon.
So far as the charge you.
This demon, Nate. Okay, stop following this demon, man. Go into the scriptures and see what you're saying, man. See what the scriptures say. See what Yahweh Shah say. Because this faithless dog, okay, the black devil formerly known as Nate, is a devil, man. it's not that hard to see, man. This is a fucking show. This is a minstrel show, man. This is a minstrel show. He's telling you to put your trust in man. He's telling you to put your trust in man and trust in man and stock it up on foods instead of having faith in Yahweh Shah. Like you can't escape death if you was judged to die. Come on, man. Cut the bullshit, man. Cut the bullshit. You know, stop following this cult of personalities. This scum lord from Gotham City. Stop following him, man. Repent and come back into the Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. Okay? And you know, with that, I'm going to say Shalom.